Hi folks, Josh Wolf with Wolf Vintage Watches here. Welcome to my shop. In this video, we're going to take a look at a 1955 Hamilton Pelham. Let's get into it. If you're new to the channel, I post vintage watch content weekly. Please consider subscribing so you don't miss any videos. And if you enjoy this video, please click the like button. It really helps the channel out. Alright, on to the basic specs of the 1955 Hamilton Pelham. The watch is 25mm wide, excluding the crown, and has a length of 29.3mm. It's 11mm thick to the top of the acrylic crystal. The lug-to-lug is 39.5mm, has a lug width of 17.5mm. The bezel and snap-on case back are 10-karat gold-filled, and the crown is unsigned. The movement is an American-made Hamilton manual wind, caliber 753, with small seconds at the 6 o'clock. The Pelham was a one-year wonder made by Hamilton in 1955. I'm not entirely sure why Hamilton only made the Pelham for 1 year, since it's a very handsome watch. Maybe it was just too similar to other watches in their lineup and didn't sell very well at the time? Hard to tell. The Pelham, like many other watches in the 40s and 50s, is a tank-style watch. Unlike, say, the Hamilton Ross, the Pelham has plenty of gentle curves, both on the case as well as the lugs. Taking a close look at the lugs, the tops and sides have an almost scalloped shape with sides that elegantly flow together. The tips of the lugs are also finely detailed with two facets that add visual interest. There is a small gap or channel where the lugs attach to the bezel, giving the appearance similar to a diamond setting of a ring. The tops and sides of the bezel are curved and beveled inwards towards the dial. This creates the illusion that the entire case is curved, but in fact it's just the top of the bezel. These curves and bevels also add a certain amount of softness to the appearance of the Pelham. The snap-on case back is fairly nondescript, but does have slightly rounded sides for comfort. Of note on this example, there is no visible plate wear on the case back or on the reverse side of the lugs. These are typically the areas that see the most wear and tear, and it's always exciting to find a watch case that looks almost as good as the day it left the factory. I was also very pleased to find there were no scratches where a less than gentle person pried off the case back. The Pelham has an applied gold numeral dial with two-tone sterling silver finish. The applied numeral 12 and pyramid-shaped markers are solid 18-karat gold. The four facets on each of the markers not only reflect the light in interesting ways, it also gives the dial added depth. The handset on this watch appears to be original, with very little, if any, patina visible. There are maybe two or three minor flecks of patina on the dial. This certainly doesn't detract from the awesomeness of the two-tone finish, though. The center field and the space outside the minute track are a polished sterling silver color. The minute track and the sub-second dial are a more creamy white color with a matte finish. The cream-colored minute track is framed by very finely painted lines. There are no painted minute markers, only the applied gold hour markers, giving the dial a very clean appearance. The sub-second dial does have painted markers every 5 seconds. The sub-second dial is sunken into the main dial, which also adds to the depth of what is a very thin watch. Over everything is the curved acrylic crystal. These so-called military acrylic crystals are much thicker and raised further out of the bezel than standard acrylic crystals, and certainly more than thin mineral glass crystals. The advantage of these thick acrylic crystals is that it keeps a shirt cuff from rubbing on the gold-plated bezel. This prevents premature wear and tear of the watch. Plus, it's easier and far cheaper to just replace a banged-up crystal than to replace a damaged bezel. I put this Pelham on an unworn, genuine calf leather two-piece strap with gold-toned buckle. Let's take a close look at the movement now that I have it out of the case. The 753 is a rectangular-shaped movement with clipped corners. It is an American-made movement and was manufactured by Hamilton in their Lancaster, Pennsylvania factory. The 750 family of movements was first introduced by Hamilton in the early 1950s when it replaced the 980 family of movements. The 19-jeweled 753 was the replacement for the slightly smaller 19-jeweled 982. Since this watch has a 753 and the serial number places the manufacturer date in 1953, It's likely it was made sometime in early 1955. The 750 family of movements, made up of the 752, 753, and 754, was replaced by caliber 770 in 1955. One of the major differences between the 753 and the 770 is the shock-protected balance jewels of the 770. The 770 was considered one of, if not the best, mechanical movements at the time, so it stands to reason that the 753 is also right up there. I serviced and restored this movement in September 2020. I'll be posting a video of that service soon, so if that's something you'd be interested in seeing, please do subscribe and hit the notification bell to catch it when it comes out. Being such a high-quality movement, I had no issues with the service. These vintage manual wind movements are usually straightforward to work on, but based on the condition of the case, and the fact that there is only one watchmaker's mark inside the case back, it appears this watch spent a majority of its life tucked away in a drawer somewhere. The movement itself wasn't too dirty, and all it took was a good thorough cleaning and re-lubrication to be ready to wear again. Watches do not belong in a drawer, they belong on a wrist. There you have it, the Hamilton Pelham, a one-year wonder from 1955. It's an interesting model, not only because it was made for a single year, but also because it was produced during Hamilton's transition from the caliber 753 to the caliber 770. The two-tone dial and the solid gold applied numeral and markers are in incredible condition. While it is a tank-style watch, the swooping, gentle curved details of the case and lugs bring added character to this vintage Hamilton watch. To see this and many other watches I have for sale, please check out wolfvintagewatches.com. Link is in the description below. As always, thank you very much for watching. To support me and my channel, please remember to subscribe, like, and share, and leave your comments and questions below. See you next time. Bye.